There you go, gang. The Lion sleeps tonight, and I want to say, I'm not certain, of course, you know, I'm wrong a lot anyway, but tokens, maybe? I got to look that up. I'm not certain. Speaking of tokens, you guys remember bus tokens? Hey, that's what I got when I got out of the service. That's what they gave me. They're going to try to help me find a job or something, whatever. And I went down there, and what was it called? I can't remember. Unemployment or something. Anyway, I went down there, and they gave me 10 bus tokens to go out and find a job. I still got an original one. One of those, I told you about my arm. Yeah, the VA had me wrap my arm in a pillow. They wanted me to do that for 90 days. I lasted 9 days, and I said, bullshit. I was tired with my all my fingers feeling like balloons, and all my fingers were just numb as hell. I said, the hell with this noise. I ain't been back yet. So I've been self-medicating myself. And stuff like that, and putting some THC cream on it. Ooh, yeah, baby. And in all seriousness, I am better off doing this stuff myself because my hand is feeling a lot better. I can actually play my guitar again without a lot of pain, and that meant a lot to me. If I could if I couldn't play my guitar good, better, and different, I would be in a world of hurt. So many times that instrument has got me out of the dumps and has helped me. It is. It's a great instrument. Pick it up. Play it. Not that hard. If I can do it, you can do it. Okay. This is what some of the people out there said about the old podcast, my podcast show. This is not from ARP. ARP sucks. I mean, they're all right. But the new magazine that's taken over is called Mars. It's the Mars magazine that stands for Medicated and Retired Seniors, which a lot of us are. And this is what my program's all about anyway. So anyways, Mars magazine said listening to Captain Boomer's... Boomers say listening to Captain Boomer is as refreshing as putting on a new Depends. Or even scheduling your next colonoscopy. Now that's... Hey, you know what? I'm proud of that fact. That's right. I am proud of that fact. Well, I got to get back to my cousin Susie, if she is still listening. There you go, babe. There you go, babe. Just for you, babe. yeah. I don't know what I'm going to do the rest. If I like this Wednesday deal. I don't know if I'm going to get any feedback. I never do. Yeah, it's kind of sad. But anyway, it's what it is. It is what it is. Okie dokie, let's have a pierogi. That's right. Pierogi. And somebody writes in and says, Captain, what's in saltpeter? I could be like, what's her name? Like Alexa, but only Captain Moon. What was really in saltpeter? I have no idea, but I took a hell of a lot of it. I know that when I was in the service. But I'll tell you one thing. It didn't work. Because I still got me some boingers. What else we got here we can jaw about? Okay, I got to get a few of my... Oh, here we go. Yeah. Okay, we went to the moon. Yeah, right. Okay. Ran out of... Now they're... Okay. They ran out of experiments. Remember that when they had that? Now they're even questioning possibly the space station up there because somebody reported or had it on film on YouTube that there was actually a live moth flying around the control panel while one of the astronauts, or whatever you want to call them, would they be astronauts? Would they be, you know, because they're really not, you know what I mean? They're not being shot up, they're not strapped in or... They're just on this big station that floats around. So anyway, whatever you call them. Space scientists or something? I don't know. Anyway, so they ran out of shit to experiment up there. Remember they were going to experiment on all sorts of different things in a weightless atmosphere, you know, environment and see if they can cure cancer, see if they can do this, what happens when you do that. Well, now, because they ran out of shit to experiment on, they say, hey, I know. Let's do beer. Beer's cool. So now they're gonna experiment on brewing some beer up there. Yeah, I guess why not? Jesus. Okay. Oh yes, this babe, she just drove me nuts. I don't know about you guys. I once dated the Noxzema girl. I did, yeah. You know the one that says take it off? Take it all off. We almost got married. Boy, was that a close shave. Oh, God. All right, help me with my therapy. Help me, will you?
Help me.
Yeah. Help me with my therapy. All right. If you guys are listening, I love you. And, okay, here we go. Now, this is going to catch on, I believe. You heard it here first on Captain Boomer's podcast. Like I said, and I've been saying it all along, you're not going to hear probably 80% of the stuff that I have out there. No, you're not going to hear it anywhere else. I don't know if that's good or bad, but at this point, I guess it doesn't matter. But anyway, remember the missing kids? And I'm not making fun of it by no stretch of the imagination. But do you remember when we had, we were kids, we had a milk carton sometimes had the missing kids on it? And people made jokes about it, and it's been in comedy movies and stuff. Remember the missing child's photograph was on the milk carton? Well, and they did that simply because in the morning, who wouldn't see a milk carton in the morning for breakfast? Almost nobody. I mean, let's face it, 'cause back in the 50s and 60s, most of us ate a regular breakfast. You know, there wasn't even McDonald's around. You know, you ate just like you'd eat all your meals. What was in front of you? Okay, but anyway, having said that, all right, I think what we're going to do, because, you know, some of us, we do drift off, and I'm not saying, you know, some of us are going to be there. I could be one, you could be one. It doesn't matter. If we get the Alzheimer's or do something, I think we ought to do it. They'll start taking the pictures. Instead of putting them on milk cartons like I did for kids, they're going to take us old seniors and stuff. If, you know, if the time arises and you get lost and you're walking around and, you know, you're drooling all over. Well, you know what I mean. And anyway, I propose that they're going to have missing senior photos be placed on medication bottles. Yep. On medication bottles, Depends, and Bengay and stuff like that. And I think that would be a good idea. Whatever. Yeah. To get your picture out there. It could be mine, could be yours, it don't matter. But I think it'd be a good way. And you betcha. Oh, God. Morning, Bob.
Morning, Captain.
So what the hell are you up to this morning? Did you make any coffee yet?
No.
Why not?
Can't find it.
Bob, it's underneath the counter. You know where the coffee machine is sitting there? It's down below there, okay? Open the doors. The little drawers, yeah, there's coffee in there. Think you can handle it?
I'll try, Captain.
And hey, you know what? And none of that decaf shit you've been slipping in on me lately either. You know? I want the real deal, pal. Okay? 100% all-American coffee. Picked by hand by Juan Valdez. Of course, by now that guy is driving around. He's having people work for him, and he's driving around checking on things probably driving a Escalade or something by now. Anyway, okay, here we go. We're going to go. Okay. All right, Bob. Talk to you later.
Bye, Captain.
All right. We almost got to slip some crickets in there, too. Yeah, I'm telling you, those crickets, they sneak in on my show. Anyway, here we go, guys. Back to a few tunes, if we can. We might even have the right button hit this time. I gotta check with my techno people here. Okay, just something just as nuts. There we go.
This world.
Duke of Earl, baby, you ain't gonna beat that. Duke of Earl. Captain Boomer is the podcast pearl. Yes, I am. And my story, I'm sticking to it. Anyway, this is interesting. Now, this is not bullshit. This is for real. After all, I did hear it on the news. So it's got to be real, right? Okay. Now, on the news today, and this is no bullshit, okay? On the news today, they said something to the effect of there's going to be 225 million cell phones are going to be receive an emergency alert system test on their phones. Okay? 225 million. Now I'm thinking to myself, damn, what the hell do they know? They being probably the government, obviously. Well, because the government, they've got media in their pocket too when they want them. You know, it's all connected. It's all, you know, one big spider web, one big connection bullshit out there, kind of. Anyway, so it's kind of scary, really is. You know, 225 million phones are going to be inundated with this system. Now, it's not an Amber Alert, stuff like that, but it is. But it is a emergency alert system test that's going to be zapped into 225 million phones. My guess is if it's not, I say, what do they know that we don't know? But at the same time, I'm hoping in a way it's not really, really bad news. What it probably really is, it's probably some stupid ad for politicians. I approve this message. Bingo! I wouldn't doubt it one bit. What do you think, Rod?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing good. How about you, Rod?
We want the group here. We want 2 pitchers of beer. We want one every 7 minutes until somebody passes out, and then after that, give us one every 5 minutes. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay, Rod. Later, bud.
Oh, hey there, Alaboyles. Hey there, Bluto. Where's my spinach? Somebody took my spinach. Well, blow me down.